Welcome to the first video of the Maker tutorial series. In this video, we will primarily cover the basics of moving around and the general user interface. If you'll notice, we start out very close to the grid. So first, let's zoom out so we can see a little more of what we are doing. Zooming out is done with the mouse wheel, but if you don't have one, you can also use page up and page down on your keyboard. We can also rotate our camera with the right mouse button and dragging our mouse. If you would like to move the camera up and down, use the home and the end buttons located near your page up and page down buttons. Now when we start this out, we are in the Parts tab. This tab is where you will spend a majority of your time in the Maker. At the top of the panel, you will see a white box with a few parts in it, Pixel 2 and T-Pixel. I will later explain the difference between these two, but let's carry on with our tour of the GUI for now. Down below, you will see three boxes for manipulating parts: position, rotation, and scale. Each one has not only three text boxes, but multiple buttons to aid in manipulation. At the top right of each box is a snap box. These control how much the parts transform with each button press or manipulation. Everything is color-coded, so you will eventually be able to look at them at a glance and know which is which. At the very bottom, you will notice some basic information: object count and triangle count. These are here so you remember not to go too overboard with blocks, as frame rate is rather important. Next to these counts is a detach button, which is useful if you want to detach a part from another without moving it. Now that we are done with the Parts tab, let's head over to Materials. You can change the tab by just clicking its name. Here you will see a cube of texturized goodness. It will display what your current material is, which currently is just white. Below it, four buttons are contained: Set and Get to set and get the material of the currently selected object, and Select All and None to select every object, or to deselect every object. The drop-down box below is used to select the material folder, which populates the list below it with different materials to use. The currently selected material is highlighted in blue, and should default to blank.dds, which is equivalent to no texture. You can change the selected material by clicking on any texture in the list. Even lower, you will find diffuse and emissive, which controls the appearance and color of the object. The difference between the two is that the higher emissive gets in luminance, the less is affected by light. Meanwhile, diffuse is always affected by light. So if I click on emissive for a moment, you will notice that a color dialog pops up. The luminance I was talking about is located here, along with all the other color values. When you hit OK, it changes the color in the emissive box, and also the appearance of the rotating cube. Below the color boxes are two checkboxes, Team Color and Skin Color. Team color only works for items, and skin color only works for hats, currently at least. Skin color takes the skin of your current player and assigns it to the material. Team color does the same, but takes the color of the team that you are currently on. The opacity slider, also below, is useful for making transparent blocks. Now let's move on to the Info and Display tab. At the top, you will see three boxes, which contain information about what you are working on. The first one, I call it, is the name of the object. My name is will be where your name is located. I'll enter in wizard now. What is it defines what you are currently working on. It defaults to monster when you first load up the maker. Let's change it to item. Notice how the ground went away and we now have a Neverdontian in its place. This is so you can figure out the scale of the item in relation to the player. Below these boxes, you will find the global scale, which defaults to 2. Below this defines what type of item you are using. If you tick hold/wear, it will change the Neverdontian's appearance, so you can work on a weapon or a hat. Mount type is so that when you save it, it will attach properly in-game. It does currently not change anything of appearance, but is necessary in order to display properly. AutoCam is useful to have the camera move to wherever you select an object. Anti-aliasing is the same as it has always been. It smooths out the jagged line so it appears smoother. It doesn't affect the object in any way, but only the appearance of when you are working on it. Show avatar size is useful for non-item blocks to measure their scale based on the world. And show ground will enable the grid to be tangible or not. This is useful if you need to place like your first object and you don't have anywhere else to place it, or if you need something to bear where 000 is. To the right is the CR and CT buttons, which revert your camera to a right side or top side view. The next sky button will change your macro background if you don't like the blue grid. I like it, so I like to keep it there. Also, if you don't want to use the keyboard shortcuts for it, buttons for manipulating the camera are at the bottom. Let's finally explain the top navigation bar. New, load, and save should be self-explanatory. Save image is used when you want to take a full-scale screenshot. This is useful if you don't have time to load it up in-game in order to test it out and to get a proper screenshot. Import is similar to loading an object, but the difference is that it doesn't erase your current construction. This means you can work on something and then import some other random object to combine them. Export.x is used if you want to rip something out of N8 and render it in any other 3D modeling software. Undo and redo goes backwards and forwards in history, at least your construction's history. The editable button shows that you can currently modify the block. It is set to locked if the object you currently have contains animation data, which is currently only used with monsters. You can unlock it if you click on the button when it says locked. And that's it for the basics. Next up, you will learn how to create an object.